Earlier this week, police discovered a grisly collection of skulls, torsos, and other body parts in a refrigerator and a large drum inside the apartment, where he drugged, strangled, and then dismembered them, and finally boiled the flesh from their skulls.
Less than an hour ago, Milwaukee authorities said that they have positively identified five more victims found in a Northside apartment. Inside, they found skulls in a file cabinet, in the refrigerator, and open boxes. The document also says there was a large kettle on the stove which held boiled body parts.
Nearly every month, in and around Seattle, a young woman was murdered or disappeared for murder.
Now, yesterday, they identified another victim, and they say they have tentative IDs on still five more. Now, authorities believe the suspect may be responsible for as many as 17 murders.
The state has no right to take your life, but you can murder other people.
I don't think anyone has the right to take my life.
Except you.
When I'm under hallucination, I do.
These voices from God, these hallucinations, do you still experience them?
Yes, I do.
Often?
Often.
Do you ever feel violent?
Yes, I do.
What do you feel like doing?
Killing people.
You still feel like killing people?
Yes.
Describe the feeling that you get when you feel like killing people.
Well, last March 11th, I was hallucinating, and I took a razor blade and I cut a man's throat.
The horror began in June 1984. Los Angeles was under siege. Death waited in the dark in the hands of a man they called the Night Stalker. The Night Stalker killed at least 13 times 13 people who were awakened in the night to face death. His killings were so sadistic and brutal that even experienced detectives were shocked.
There was evidence of vaginal and anal trauma.
Ted Bundy had a talent for murder, for mutilations even more repulsive than those described by the judge.
His remains were discovered inside what some now call the suspect's little house of horror.
I tried to keep the person alive by inducing a zombie-like state.
Do you think it murdered me, Jeff?
Yes. The long and short of it was that I again knocked her unconscious.
Maybe I should have killed 400-500 people, then I would have felt better. Then when I felt like I really offered society something.
You murdered your own son?
Yes, I did.
Wife did it.
He was a sacrifice. I was to murder 3 million people with planet Earth. At the end of murdering all the people on Earth, I was going to murder my own family and then take my own life and become God.
Three, one, two. another person and view them as just an object, an object for pleasure instead of a living, breathing human being. I was branching out. That's when the cannibalism started, eating of the heart. It was a way of making me feel that they were a part of me. I had these obsessive desires and thoughts wanting to control them, possess them permanently. And as my obsession grew, I was saving body parts such as skulls and skeletons. I can't think of anything that would have stopped me.
I feel old, into your skull. Poor song is in it, keep you alive. 2 days later, you die by something my friend. But even in death, you will be mine.
cops knew who I was and let me kill the rest of those guys and turn me into a serial killer.
Or Hacer frente al enemigo.
Que el enemigo no tenga poder sobre nosotros y que el hijo de la desgracia no tenga.